health news now, allergies and asthma can go hand in hand, and the lingering pollen season is a problem for millions of Americans dealing with some form of asthma.
But now doctors are better able to tailor their treatment. News 8's medical reporter Jocelyn Mementa is on the scene with what one Connecticut hospital is doing.
There is no cure for asthma, but doctors are able to control their patients' symptoms. Now they can even go further with individualized treatment.
Take a deep breath in.
Nicholas Giancarelli has allergies, and in the spring, it triggers a mild form of asthma, inflammation in airways of the lungs.
They're saying that they think I'm breathing funny.
But the 7-year-old takes it in stride.
One adult said that I was like gasping. It sounded like I was gasping for air.
Usually in the spring, he'll start coughing like crazy. I hear him coughing at night. I hear him coughing all day long.
Coughing, shortness of breath, that's when kids like Nicholas
just breathe in and out.
See pediatric pulmonologist Dr. Jacob Henn at Bridgeport Hospital, where pulmonary function testing confirms the diagnosis of asthma.
This is measuring resistance in his airways.
You're going to put this in your mouth.
But it is this handheld device, the Mino, that paints a much clearer picture for Dr. Henn.
Some asthma, the white cells are specific white cells called eosinophils, and they are linked to allergies. And these white cells produce a gas called nitric oxide. And we can now measure that. The exhaled nitric oxide allows us to actually measure inflammation in the airways and tell us if the inflammation is increased or not. So then we can tailor our therapy specifically to reduce that inflammation.
Patients with severe asthma with increased inflammation can expect a higher dose of medication. For Nicholas, with seasonal asthma, that means an inhaler to open his airways. Patients with persistent asthma also get a daily inhaler. It prevents symptoms and reduces inflammation. On the scene at Bridgeport Hospital, Jocelyn Mementa, News 8.